my loyal meddlers. Thank you all so much for being so forgiving about my having to finish finals instead of filming April's Medal of the Month for you. But I hope you all enjoy a good dose of Teresis, because that is the band that I chose for April's Medal of the Month. As usual, I would like to apologize ahead of time if I mispronounce anything. Teresis is a band from Hämeenlinna, Finland. Among all of their fans, they're known as battle metalers. But among the rest of the world, they're known as a Finnish folk metal band. Forged in the flames of imagination in 1997 by the lead singer, Matthias Nygaard, and his companion, Jussi Wikström, Teresis was created and named after one of the ancient Finnish gods of war. In 1998, they recorded their very first album that I can't pronounce. The album, however, remains unreleased due to the band's overall dissatisfaction with the sound quality of the album. However, no one was daunted by the failure of this first demo CD. In 2000, they went on and recorded a new one, The Heart of Teresis. They distributed many copies of this CD to some of their loyal underground fans and to some potential record labels, and in 2003, they were signed with Century Media Records. It didn't take them long to get started on the very first album that we all know and love as Battle Metal. Battle Metal was recorded in the Soundsuite Studios in France in December of 2003, and also a little bit more recordings were done in Finland in early 2004. The album itself was released in mid-2004. Immediately following the release of Battle Metal, the band made tons of appearances at most of the major metal festivals in Europe. Unfortunately though, in 2005, one of the original guitarists, George Lasko, was involved in a serious car accident, resulting in some very severe spinal cord injuries. The announcement was made that he was leaving the band on July 12th of 2006. That didn't stop these metal warlords from working on their next album, though. In early 2007, Teresis released The Varangian Way. Jussi Wikström recorded all of the guitars himself. But only a few months before the release of The Varangian Way, one of the accordion players, Antti Laurila, decided that he was to leave the band. He announced it on the forum, and it was later confirmed by Matthias. While the band was on tour in January of 2008 in Amsterdam, their other accordion player, after missing their flight out of Amsterdam, disappeared. Since then, there has been very little contact between him and the band. As a result, their current accordion player, Netta Skog, was introduced to the band. She was only to be a temporary accordion player at first, but later became a more permanent member. I had this hair before I even knew who she was. The change in members, however, didn't stop the band from touring the rest of the world at all. Teresis returned home in 2009 to begin work on their next album. That album happens to be their most recent album, and is titled Stand Up and Fight. It was released in Europe in February, and then in March in the rest of the world. Stand Up and Fight is a loose continuation of the story that took place on the Varangian Way. This album also, in the first time in Teresis' history, features real string and horn sections instead of synthesized ones. Teresis is currently finishing their tour off in Europe, but will most likely be touring the rest of the world soon. The current members are as follows and are hopefully pronounced correctly. Also known as the Warlord, Matthias Nygaard is on the lead vocals. Doing all of the guitars himself, his loyal companion, Jussi Wikström. On the bass is Hannes Horma. The guy that does all of the killer violin solos is Olli Vanska. On the accordion is the beautiful and talented Netta Skog. And on the drums behind it all is Thomas Lehtonen. I was introduced to Teresis through my boyfriend, who showed me Battle Metal on YouTube. At first I thought it was alright. It was a different kind of metal than I was used to, so it kind of took a little bit of getting used to. But now I'm basically in love with this band. I went out and bought the album Battle Metal, which is awesome, and then later in February, just this past February, I went to go see them in concert. I bought the download card for their brand new album Stand Up and Fight, and I got it signed by two of the members. One of them was Olli. He was very cool and very funny. And the other one, it was not Hannes, the bassist. He was off doing something else, so they had to bring in somebody else that they knew that could play the bass for Teresis. And he was really cool. We talked to him after the show for about an hour and a half. He was cool. And that concert was amazing. Even though Teresis was only one of the openers at that concert and only played about four songs, it was still amazing. We painted our faces and everything because we went just to see Teresis. Yes, we all painted our faces. My favorite song is difficult to choose right now because I'm listening to everything on the new album, and I, of course, really like Stand Up and Fight, but I also really like The Great Escape. But one of my absolute favorite songs is probably Rasputin. I really love that song. It's so catchy. Okay, that's all I've got for you guys for April's Medal of the Month. Again, thank you for understanding my need to postpone it. Please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. I make a new video every month. I really do, even though I postponed this one. But I promise, I make a new video every month featuring a different metal band. So thank you guys for watching. Be sure to share this with your friends and go get their new album, because it's awesome. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.
I use my own thread to join the Varangian God of glory and the fight. Red has not and black has night. Lies a banner as we cross the east for the king of the free.
That is so Finnish. That's awesome. So thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you next time. Metal on. That was gay. The hell.